Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to use the template engines with Express application. Express is capable of handling server-side template engines. Template engines allow us to add data to the view and generate HTML dynamically. You can render the output as a plain HTML without using the template engines, but this will not give much flexibilities to handle HTML data and also clutter the server data. At runtime, the template engine replaces the variables in a template file with actual values and transforms the template into an HTML file sent to the client. This approach makes it easier to design an HTML page. We can use popular template engines with Express. So let me show some of the template engines. Yeah, you can see here, like these are like we have more template engines. So these are some of the popular engines. Jade, this is the default one. Then PUG, then Vash, EJS. EJS means embedded JavaScript. Then Mustache, Dust, then Nunjucks, Handlebars, atpl, then haml. Yeah, as I said, like the default for the Express application generator is Jade. But we can use the other ones listed as well. So even we have more than this. To render template files, we can set the application settings. Also, we can set the view engine we want to use by setting the view engine property. I will show you that in the demo. I am going to use EJS for our demo. EJS simply stands for embedded JavaScript. It is a simple templating language slash engine that lets its user generate HTML with plain JavaScript. While there are several templating systems out there with their merits and demerits, I personally use EJS because of its simplicity in syntax and logic. It's also very easy to set up. Let's see the demo now. So yeah, as a first step, let us create a project. I'm going to create, I'm in the Express templates folder. Just say npm init. Okay, I'm going with the same thing. I'm not changing any value. Just this is fine. Just say yes. And now we need to install some modules, mainly Express and the EJS templating engine. So for that, execute this command: npm install Express space EJS, then put save. Okay, now the modules are installed. So now let me go back to the folder. Okay, here create a file with the name server.js. Okay, here we can configure the Express module. Now let us create the template views. So let me create a folder with the name views under the root folder. This is the default folder. Express.js looks for the view templates, but you can keep the views into custom folders. So that case we need to do some configuration changes in the Express application. So that I can show it later. Yeah, always the folder should be under the root folder views. Create a folder pages under views. I am going to create a folder pages under this views. So you can keep all the main pages into this folder. Then under this, I am going to create a file called index.js. So this to support the index page. Okay. Now let me come back. Now I am going to create a folder called partials here again under views. So this will hold all the partials, all the like child templates. The example, like you can keep the header, footer, any kind of child templates you can keep it here. Now under this partials, I'm going on creating a three or four files. One is head.js. This will provide the head section to the template. Head.ejs. Another one is header.ejs. Header.ejs. visual header section. Then I will create something called footer.js, provides a footer. Then I am creating one more file called main content. This is the main body content. .ejs. Okay. Now let me copy the content, required content. First of all, I will. Okay. Yeah. Under index.ejs, I am going to copy pages. I will explain that. Pages index. So here if you see, this is just a skeleton or the main template. So here under the head section, I am just including the partial head.ejs whatever we created. Then under the header section, again including the header.ejs, then main content.ejs, then footer.ejs. So just it will include all the required files. All those data is configured under this, either one of these files. The head.ejs will store all the JavaScript or style mappings. Then header.ejs will have the header content, title and all those things. This is the main part, so body content. So then footer, like it is a, it will have the footer messages. Okay, now let me copy other file contents also. Yeah, this is for head.ejs. So here just I am going and keeping the title, then I am linking the bootstrap and some styles. So, I will go to the views, partials, head.ejs. I'm just going and adding this. So this is, as I said, this is very simple thing, title and the style sheet. Now go back, I will copy the header.ejs content. So this is just having a navigation. Okay, header.ejs. Here if you see, it's a navigation. So I am having some dynamic data here. Here I am saying welcome, then name, data.name, 2 hour EJS template demo. So this is the one dynamic data. Then I have some link. This is the header.ejs. Now let me go back and copy the main content.ejs. It's having some divs. Here if I see, like I am just having welcome to templating using this one, then I have some dynamic data. I have a list of links, data.links, then I am looping through that and I am displaying the ordered link. So yeah, it's very simple. So you can add whatever based on your use cases. Now the next one is, let me put the footer.ejs. Let me go into footer.js. Here it's very simple, it's having the copyright message, but I am passing the year, like the data.year. Yeah, so this is fine now. So we configured all the templating now. So if I go back, what I did is, like under this root folder, I created a folder with the name views, then under that pages and partials. Under pages, I created a index.js file. This is the index page, the content for the index page. Now this is just a skeleton, template skeleton, and including the partials. Under the partials folder, I created all these required sub template files, footer, header, and main content.js. Okay, the template is now ready. So now, like, we need to create a express service to render the HTML output by combining the template, whatever we created, and the dynamic data, because our template is expecting some dynamic data. So for that, what I will do is, I already created a file with the name server.js. Let me show that under the folder. So I will edit that file and add the required content. So let me go here. Okay, let me go and put it here. If you see here, like I'm including the express, then creating a express object. This is the data I am going to send. The data is a JSON type, you can send any complex data. Here I am just sending name, tech forum, then year, this is another value, then date, get full year, then links. So this is the array type, test 1, test 2, test 3. Now here if you see, this is the one I was explaining, the views folder. So by default it will consider the views folder, but if you want to change the folder name to your custom folder, you can do like this, views, your custom folder. Always the folder should be in the root folder, or you give the relative path. So now here like dot, then you can say custom folder. My case I am going to views, so I don't want to add this. Then you can set the view engine type. So as I said, like we have multiple engines, template engines. I am going with EJS, so here you have to say view engine, what is the type of the engine. Then I am supporting, I am the index page, slash app.get, get service. Then I am rendering this response. This is important, like response.render. Then what is the main template name? For our case it's pages, under pages folder, index. Then what is the data I need to pass? Data, this is the data object or name used in this template, data, this data. This data is the actual data object what you created here. So you can change it accordingly. So now, yeah, so here you are rendering, here what you are doing is you are saying this is my template, this is my data. So the template engine going to replace the dynamic data in the template and create the static HTML, the final HTML that will be sent back to the client. Now I am listening like this app in 8080, then I am just typing it. Yeah, so now the configurations are ready. Let us go and start the server. So for that I will go back here, just to say node server.js. Yeah, the server is started now. Let's go and access the application now. I will go to localhost 80. Yeah, I think I have some problem. Okay, that is my mistake. So under the pages I created a file with the name index.js. It should be EJS. So I am going to rename this to EJS. Okay, done. Now I will go back. We can stop and start the server. Okay, then you can access it. Okay, that is my mistake. So I did not added this dot here. Instead of that I put a comma. That's a problem. So let me rename the file. Okay, done. Now let me go and restart it. Okay, done. Now let me go and access. Yes. If you see here, like this is the dynamic data. So we passed it from the server.js or the service to the template engine. So the template engine replaced the dynamic data, the placeholder with this dynamic data, and also the, you see here, tech forum, this and the. Then also if you see the copyright, we are just passing the year. So it's displaying the 2020. Okay, thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video with another topic.